Hey guys, welcome back to FACEIT TV here for the road to Quakecon. It's day two. It's the team situation. It's a situation with teams.
It is. There's a big team situation right here. And Deliberate Murder are losing the team situation at the moment. They got a smashing in the TDM. I was expecting it to be close, but it just simply wasn't. MD were playing crazy good.
Yeah.
Now we know CTF maps. It's going to be Infinity, picked by MD, then Pillbox, picked by Deliberate Murder. And it doesn't even matter what the tiebreaker map is, because there's a good chance we won't see it. But
yeah,
I'm really interested to see how the Russians are going to play anyway, because I really never associated Deliberate Murder with CTF. And to see how they've done their homework and if they're how much they're prepared for QuakeCon will be interesting to see if they can hold their ground at least a little bit versus MD. I'd like them to get some caps. It'd be nice to get the caps, even if they've already lost three caps or something, to see them being able to run the flag would be nice. Or just seeing them being able to play some solid defense as well, just preventing caps from happening. You know, the interesting thing about
CTF. Play some basic CTF.
Yeah. But the interesting thing about CTF, though, is you can have a team that is like they're all in positive net and they're just fragging over and over. And you can have a team that are struggling to get kills. You know, their attacker might be on 5 frags and 60 deaths, but that team can still win.
Yes, yeah, I've seen that happen before, actually. Yeah.
So it's not really as much about the fragging as about the points that really matter is when you cap the flag. And the thing is that the thankless job of being an attacker, and some of the maps you'll see at least, is like, yeah, so you're probably going to look really terrible on the scoreboard. You might only get 20 frags. You might die 80, 90, 100 times, but you're going to make the difference as to whether or not
win. It used to be that case that some frag runners would never even really engage anybody. They would even shoot at people. That used to be
I played as a CTF player. You started in TDM a lot more a long time ago. For me, when I started playing, it's very much a CTF my thing. And looks like Winz going to be attacking early. He has the medkit. Tops himself up, and Zyrinx is already touching the flag. Not going to be for very long, but he's asserting himself on the map, and now Winz is going to come back from the other side. He kind of did a flank maneuver there. He's got some support from Linkin, and Dan, this isn't looking very good. No. This isn't looking good at all. He's being chased a little bit. 10 HP, make that 5.
Oh.
You can't shoot through that little grill, and that is going to be first cap in 42 seconds.
Oh my god. That's not good. That's not a good start here.
They only just picked up the quad. Oh, okay, Latrommi! Latrommi's got the flag! Hang on, let's see if we
can do this. Let's go.
Where are you, Latrommi? Latrommi?
He's dead.
Oh, bastard.
He did.
We got a flag guy. Hang on, let me see if I can work out these binds. So it's nice though, at least the Deliberate Murder guys have got something to play with, but we're switching around a lot at the moment.
Yeah, I think it's going to grab a quad. He's straight in there as well. Linkin is always really fun to watch in CTF because his movement is so sick. He's probably the best player with movement, I think. He's going to use the medkit. That's going to give you, it's like having a mega you can use when you press the use button and just store it. And, it's going to be Linkin and eliminated. So, I mean, Deliberate Murder just have to stabilize it. I mean, right at the start of the map, sometimes crazy stuff can happen because you're like going, picking up the weapons, you're going, getting the armor. But you should have enough routine, I think, in your team that shouldn't be able to happen at the same time. Because you can have players like attackers early on. They can if there's something far away that you need as a defender, they can go pick it up, drop it for you. If it's a weapon, so you don't have to go too far afield. So that's kind of incredible that they managed to make a cap so fast.
Yeah, interesting. Fortune is the defender, but he was so low then. He should have been crying for a teammate, saying, "Please help me quickly." Great defense from Fortune. He gets the spawn, gets onto the rocket launcher quickly, and manages to stop the enemy from running across the map with a flag. So it's a nice recovery from him. But you know, as the defender, you really need to be communicating. I need help. I need some more resources. Back me up over here very quickly. And your teammates have got to be so responsive.
Yeah, and something you can do as well is when your teammates are running with the flag, you can try and boost them by shooting them, because the team damage only goes to the armor and not to the health of the players. So you remove their armor, but you won't kill them. So you can really speed them up on their escape.
Oh, nicely done, Latrommi. Bring down Winz there. Is he going to continue? You know, as an attacker, especially if you're running a two offense strategy, you need to really coordinate with the other attackers so that you're kind of flanking it at the same time. Like very much you saw Winz and Zyrinx doing at the beginning. Got Linkin though with a quad. He's very low on the health. He's just going to bring it back into his base. And there, look, this is what you can't do in TDM. You can drop that for your teammate. Tox is going to take it, and it looks like he might just play a bit more defensively with it this time, but actually, he's getting hurt a lot. Latrommi's going to be able to pick up the flag. Tox is so weak, and was almost at a little bit of risk just then. Oh, winz, that's not how you rocket jump, but fortunately, he messed up that rocket jump so bad, he didn't even do any damage to himself.
Yeah, Tox kind of fluffed up that defense. Sometimes you'll see that the quad gets dropped to the main, like, the red mega taking defender, so he can just go on a massive quad run, but they don't really need to do that, so I recognize that. It's really sick stuff indeed.
Where's the flag carrier? I'm trying to find him. Oh no, it looks like he's just lost him.
He did.
My wireless keyboard is just crying on my shoulder at the moment.
Alright, so Tox is just going for this typical defensive stuff, and we'll see him being the defense man pretty much in every situation. I would have liked to have seen Spider Crossings as well, just because it would have just been fun to see him in the middle, just raiding everywhere. It's like 100% rail.
Yeah, I think we'll probably see that get picked up on the next series that we see when we get to CTF. But we shan't be having it here. I believe if we do get to a tiebreaker, it would be Ironworks, as I understood. Unfortunately, again, he hasn't got much in the way of armor at all. And this item's not up. Oh, it is. I've misread on there. We've got the red team mega and the blue team mega on the left side of the screen, and obviously the yellow as well. No reds over here.
So Pavel's going to go in now and see what he can get done. It's going to be winz, though. He's going to pick up a flag and see if he can get out of there. He's got a teammate close by, if he can just get out into mid. But the win is not controlled actually by his team. Latrommi got the kill, and that control is going to turn into a nice return there from Latrommi. That's so important. That's why having mid is really, really crucial. It allows your flag carriers to actually make it away out of the enemy base safely through into your base. So mid control always very strong.
Very nice for Pavel as well, getting himself a little bit of armor. He's got the LG to work with as well. Going to be able to steal the enemy yellow. And Pavel's going to be dropped the flag, so he's got quad. Oh, but what the hell just happened there? The two rockets just flew straight at him. Took so much damage. And now winz is going to be able to get the enemy flag. Winz? What were you thinking there? Just yes. Walking into his panel for some reason, that was very unusual.
Yeah, it's always really fun to see the very good flag runners, because we see Latrommi picking up a flag here. He's going to get trapped and promptly fragged, I should think. There it is. But the cool thing about it is that it's all about outsmarting the defense, because you go for all these decisions where you have to, like, drop down, or you know, which route are you going to take, basically. You got to try to basically just outsmart the defenders who are trying to cut you off. Like, what route do you think that they think that you're going to take?
That's the really fun part about being an attacker as well, because sometimes it might take you forever to get the flag, but as soon as you do, and as soon as that defender's cleared out, you really get to sort of have fun thinking about that strategic side of it. And that's when you've got to be calling out to your teammates, and your teammates are saying, right, well, at the moment this route is currently clear, and then you're trying to predict, well, which route is going to be clear in the next 5 or 10 seconds. And that's where you start building that that story for how you're going to get back to your base with it.
Yeah, you typically don't want to take fights unless you absolutely have to, as you want to try to keep your armor stack alive as you approach mid, and so that can be the very difficult thing. So fighting, this is why we're talking about, like, you know, earlier, fighting skills as a flag carrier, not super important. Historically, there's been some really sick flag runners that have not been good fighters at all.
Yep. You know, a player like ID, one of the best attackers in the world on the American teams, he's playing with Dehang this year. He has just got an amazing aim as well. He's just got, like, everything you really need to be excellent. And it's like the MD flag is going to be put back to base just there. But watch Quakecon 23rd to 26th of the month, and you'll see the Americans getting on the CTF action as well. Don't worry about the Americans playing TDM. That's not going to matter at all.
Yeah, Zyrinx picks up the red flag here. Perhaps be able to get out. There's been a lot of disturbance in the red base, so he might be able to make his way out of there. Winz is going to be trying to cut a path for him as well in mid, and he's going to take down two quick kills there. But Zyrinx is going to be cleared to go. There it is. The green light is sounded, but it's actually going to be Latrommi who's going to return again. But equally as important as it is for just being able to juke and drive the defense as the flag carrier, also you need an attacker that's very good at hitting the shots, so you can displace the defense and give opportunities to your mate who wants to run with the flag. And
yeah, absolutely.
So mid control kind of very back and forth at the moment for these teams. We're not really seeing one team locking down mid completely, and despite that cap in the first 40 seconds, Deliberate Murder is stabilized.
That's actually good, though. That's a really good point. I'm glad to see that they've not been giving up too many caps. The fact, though, that Tox is in mid with 200-100 stack is pretty scary. But we'll see if Deliberate Murder is going to be able to deal with that.
It could be worse. The quad could be spawning right now, so he could use that stack on the quad and maybe push into the base and just wreck everybody. But at this point in time, he's going to get most of his health and armor removed. But he did a good job in displacing the players who are moving through middle and just making sure that his teammates can get clear entry. Because that also means your attacker is going to go into the enemy base with more stack if they pick something up towards the offense. But the quad is spawning 15 seconds now, so you would expect maybe Linkin to do something really huge with this if he has something to work with.
Yeah, here we are. Tox is going to be setting up inside. It looks like a few MD players are with him. Deliberate Murder playing on the lower side of the map. That's Cooler just going down to Zyrinx's Plasma. And it looks like Latrommi was trying to make a play on the flag while MD were focused on the quad damage, but he's not going to be successful with his endeavors. Zyrinx going to be dropping that for Tox, who's got a tiny bit of armor. Not much more than what Zyrinx had, but it's Tox.
Yeah, so this is what we were talking about earlier, and although, as you said, he's not actually that stacked, but usually the defensive player can just come out of his shell with the quad damage to just destroy the defense. He gets a lot of damage done. Kuda's going to pick up the quad, though, after the successful elimination of Toxic, and that will be that situation handled. But Zyrinx, in midst of the chaos, picks up the flag. He's trying to make his way out. He's got a little bit of armor as well. He's going for it
really nice down route.
On low. And here it is, making it across middle into the blue base. And Zyrinx is looking pretty fantastic. This should be another cap.
Oh, that was such a sick route by Zyrinx. That was amazing offensive play. Honestly, I think that's where the inexperience in CTF comes for Deliberate Murder and where it comes to really bite them in the back. Because they didn't have the foresight in that route to expect him to rotate, come back towards the middle area. They were chasing him directly instead of trying to cut him off. You know, you want to immediately get to the cutoff zone. You don't want to be constantly behind him. So yeah, really sick from Zyrinx just messing with them.
And I think Toxic is being much more active than the main defender of Deliberate Murder, because he's all over the place. And look at his stack, it's really strong. He's picking up all the yellows up high.
He's playing really far forward as well, isn't he? He's often in mid. He's got the stack going. You know, Deliberate Murder are being slow to be able to do the damage to him. And having that extra presence in mid makes it even harder for Deliberate Murder to push into base and make that where the action should be, where they can take the flag.
And one of the harder things about the job that Toxic has to do is if he does go offensive like he did all the way into the enemy flag room with the quad, you lose kind of the idea and maybe even some item timings of what's going on in your own base. And you have to be, Toxic has to know everything about what's going on in his own base, so he knows when items are spawning, when he can take them, you know, where the enemies can be. But by leaving the base, you lose that sense. So you can see that he didn't lose anything, actually. And he's going to be just doing more and more damage with this railgun long range. Can he get the kill on the quad pickup? He will actually just get landed, I think, a pixel rail there onto Kula. So he's low, but... And that's going to leave the quad in a kind of ineffectual... Well, it's going to leave it to be ineffectual in the hands of Kula.
Yeah, he might get himself a yellow in 10 seconds. Yep, he will, but what can you do? You can get to the other side of the map. And then not much else. And he's going to get knocked off his little perch as well. So he's got to go down to the lower side of the map. Is getting a couple of frags, doing some good damage. And Pavel takes Linkin down extremely low. But this is probably going to get reset. I'm not sure what Deliberate Murder will actually be able to do with that productively.
Yeah, winz is back in here. And he's going to go down very quickly. But Meltdown have been finding the really good opportunities around the power-up. The power-ups, generally speaking, they're being quite consistent on those pickups. So, I mean, they're either using the defensively if they're like weak on the pickup, or in the case of Toxic able to convert it into an aggression, they're just getting their opportunities from that. So it feels like if Deliberate Murder were able to have a defender be as active and strong as Toxic, they could really bring this back in. But that's a hard ask.
Yeah. I was looking at Toxic's accuracy a bit. Oh, well, we're gonna be switched over, so too late. How's Latrommi doing? Linkin way too weak there. Fortune, well, he's living on the edge almost constantly. He's got next to nothing to work with, and yeah, winz is just going to rocket him down. He's going to get a flag touch now. How can he weave his way out of this very similar route to Zyrinx that he's taking at the moment? He's gone to mid with only Fortune in his way, and then Pavel as well yelled out to come and help out. Only 2-0 for the time being. Really, they're minimizing the damage as much as possible, but I still feel like up until this point, Deliberate Murder have been at a massive disadvantage, but this is nice team play. They got the flak to mid, but you can see there are three MD players rushing towards them, and they just keep on running into objects. And it stopped them from being able to get a cap.
Here we go, Toxic again with the quad, but he's not really got the stack to use it, so it's just going to help him more efficiently just stack up in the base. And that's always the most important thing, that your main defender is stacked up. But he's actually going to take it defensively here after picking up the Mega. He's going straight in. It's not as if they need more caps, but Toxic is just going for it right now. He's got the flag. He's in, and he's out. He's got teammates to support him. He's getting low, but he makes it across too.
Yeah, and that's his teammates, LG, just pushing him along a little bit with 12 health left. That is going to be cap number 3 there for Meltdown.
God damn.
Such a nice quad run as well. At the same time, just getting all the frags he needed to. Extremely efficient run. And now Lincoln's got a touch as well. Going to have a little rocket jump. He was on solo HP anyway. Latrommi is going to find him up at the top ledge. Just scavenging for a weapon. Oh, wow. Winz just turns up and blasts him away anyway. Wasted opportunity.
Sometimes as well, when you have your main defender going crazy like that, you can have a situation where the defense at home is so weak that like the cross steal situation can happen, but you know, in a way the enemy takes your flag, you take their flag, and mm-hmm. you can't cap it because your flag's not on the podium. You got to go for the return. That didn't happen though, so that really sucks for the Remoto. They just lost another straight up cap here. So yeah. You can see that Meltdown are finding multiple ways. Well, actually, that said, it usually comes off the back of Toxic's aggression with the quad. The second cap was like that as well. He ran into the base, he killed everyone, he died. But Zyrinx, in the midst of all of it, or the chaos, was able to find the cap, so...
I think the floodgates have been opened, and it's just caps coming out right now. This time, Lincoln actually has got some stack to work with, but he's spotted a lot of green cyber demons in front of him, and he's not actually going to be allowed to go through. But Winz is right back on the flag anyway, he's just waiting for his turn to have a touch of it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not really the most amazing team player. I would expect Winz to be supporting him more directly, but because all the Russian players are so focused on where the flag carrier is, Winz can actually do that, and it's not a bad play at all. Winz gets the flag back once again, it's across the map, and yeah, the water is just rushing through. 5-0. And it's at that point, even though Deliberate Murder had a good 10 minutes of play where they were stabilizing, as you said, I think now the pressure is just too much for them. And MD have just unlocked that kind of ability to do it. And it might be sort of Deliberate Murder being a little bit impatient as well and wanting to get to the next map.
Yeah, it was also in Meltdown, they just started taking some risks. Like, for example, Toxic going aggressive with that quad, which had, I think, 15, 14 seconds left on it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he didn't have to do that. He could very well have just used it to stack up a bit more because he didn't have much stack in the defense. I think if they were playing a team that they thought was better, with
yep.
more respect, I think that he wouldn't have done that because they already had two flags in advantage. So yeah, I think it's just the fact that Meltdown can assert themselves in with the individual skills so heavily here, and also that CTF skill, because it is. I mean, Zyrinx, he came from CTF and Instagib and stuff and Clan Arena, and Winz and Linkin have always been, well, not Winz necessarily, but Linkin's been a prolific CDF player, and
yeah.
Toxic, you know, took to CTF after TDM. I mean, he played a bit more CTF before he really got into Duel, and of course he made his name, so he, you know, became the Terminator really truly in Duel. That's really where he made his name
yeah.
fully, but he started out TDM as well, so it's a team that has so much CTF experience, it's very hard to contest with that. Kula never really had played team games that much. He played TDM here and there back in the days, but it was never a focus for him like these players from Meltdown.
Yeah, and Lincoln actually was widely regarded as the best attacker in Europe as well.
Yeah.
Some would argue in the world, but you know, yep. if you're not in a CTF tournament winning team, then I think ID is going to be claiming that one. Although it's heavily under contention this year, I've got to say. I think this is the year where Europeans can do it, but they're still not the favorites.
Yeah, I mean, you make a good point. I mean, we talked earlier about how AAA and Against All Authority and their ability mm-hmm. in CTF, they're always such a legendary CTF team. France has always produced a lot of CTF talent in Quake, it would
yeah.
seem. I mean, before Linkin, I think that the Foot was largely considered the best attacker in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Again, you know, not necessarily counting the North American players, but the European amongst the European players. So I guess in Europe, he was considered the best attacker.
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, it's a shame actually that the Foo disappeared. He never played Quake Live, as far as I know.
That's a shame. Right, we've got Latrommi. It's a rare sight to see a deliberate murder player with a flag. The furthest they've really got the flag was just into their side of the base, like into the doorways just across the midsection. But other than that, they've not had much luck here on an Infinity. Pillbox could go better for them if they picked that. Although I was actually surprised they wanted to go with that map. But maybe since they're newer to CTF, they wanted a newer map so they don't have to catch up on years of meta changes or whatever you want to call them. Latrommi with the flag again. He's going to try brain his way through the map. He's been discovered. Zyrinx. Yeah, sorry, mate, but your time is up. They know exactly where you are. And the light that comes off the flag as well, it's not like you can hide very easily. But Latrommi's actually doing a good job. That mecha was up in 1 second. And he's not going to be able to take it. Yeah, Zyrinx is just going to pinch that. Linkin getting a touch on the flag very briefly. Red flag returned. And, you know, the max amount of caps you can get in a CTF game is 8. So that's basically if a team gets 8 caps, then the game will stop immediately. You just don't want to let the other team get 8. It's like being mercy limited in TDM, for instance.
Is that not a setting, though, that you can turn on and off? Or?
It's just been a standard since I can remember. In Quake Live, it's always been 8 being the max amount of caps. And generally, you don't get there unless it's extremely one-sided, so...
So is it 8 ahead, or if you get to 8-0 first?
Get to 8. Oh, so it doesn't have to be 8-0, it could be 8-3.
So it could be 7-7, and the team that gets 8 wins.
Yeah, I've never seen that, though.
7-7, yeah, that would be ridiculous.
That would be insane.
8 players playing offense at once would be fun.
Yeah, but what's really exciting in CTF is when you start getting towards the overtime, so if it's maybe 0-0 or 1-1, because then it's not in duel, it's not like, oh, you get an extra 2 minutes to see if you get a cap, and then it's changed, or it's not sudden death. Well, it is sudden death, but the whole point is that every minute, the respawn timers are delayed an extra second, so it takes a second longer to respawn. And that's where it starts getting really, really tense. But that is going to be GG on map 1 here, 5-0. Look at Tox there, 67-14. And you say Linkin with 51-66, and Winz 42-60. Oh, Zyrinx, all of those players are... the last two players are negative on kill death. But, you know, they're attacking all the time, and that's really what attackers have to do. The others... Yeah, even Fortune in Defender, he's 36-26.
Yeah.
That's a big difference to how Tox is going.
I mean, that's what it should happen. I mean, if you're playing like a really good game with your flag defender, let's not forget that Toxic went offensive too. I mean, he should be maybe like 10 deaths or something. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's how it used to be a long time ago. Even with the 5 players, you know, usually that's around, you don't want your defender to die more than 10 times or something.
And in a map like Troubled Waters, it's very normal to see defenders die maybe only 2 or 3 times in an entire game, because the amount of resource they have around them and the fact that they're not really going to go past their side of the base, essentially. They'll go up and look at mid. But that's why killing the defender sometimes is such a big thing in a map where it's far more located around the flags rather than the midsection.
Yeah, I mean, something, for example, I always used to heavily try to achieve in CTF and CPM, because that's where I played the most CTF or CPM. And the thing that I'd always try to get my team to do, especially with the attackers, is sometimes make sure that we're getting, let's say if it's like spider crossings, let's say we're taking our upper red, right? Mm-hmm. And we have our main flag defender, who's not taking the red, he's taking the megas or something. And I would always like to get the guy who's taking red, the high def, to actually come with the two attackers at the timing of the enemy's red armor and then go and take that with the attack, because then that makes the attacker's lives so much easier, that you don't have this super stacked player that's always able to kill you. You can actually fight him. And so if you can actually kill him, you can actually spend a lot more time trying to wait in the enemy side of the base, keeping yourself alive whilst your team is saying, okay, mid is actually under control or not.
Yeah.
So you can actually get the flag out more often than not, and you actually know what's happening more often than not, buy yourself time. And so that was actually really cool. And I think you could actually make in CPM for attackers work, although not people didn't really do it because of the way that you can move around, and because armors was actually much stronger, and the rails back then were weaker and so on.
Yeah.
So yeah, CPM CDF is quite fun.
It is. It's really hectic.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It is absolutely nuts. But I mean, it's a good point though about you have to time the opponent's items as well. An attacker's job isn't just to try and get the flag and sneak in little ways, not do any damage whatsoever, but somehow make a cap happen. You know, they have to be timing the enemy items. They have to be relaying a lot of information to the teammates.
Yeah, they need to be attacking Toxic, basically. Okay, how is Toxic? Because it's like, we want to destabilize defense. What's one of the best ways to do that? Just like get Toxic low, like kind of low, kind of before a power up's gonna be spawning, then you can he can't be too effective on the power up, and he can't push too far out and make sure his team gets it. And if your team gets it, now you're against a weak defense, so you should be more able to cap and stuff. So that's always fun to coordinate with your teammates as well.
I think
we got the next map coming. What was the next map again?
It's
a
pillbox.
Pillbox. Okay.
So that's only a one power up map. We are going to see red armors and stuff on that map as well. Some sneaky things on there. I got to say, it's not the map that I was focused on. When I was around CTF a lot, Pillbox was not in play. So it's going to be interesting to see how these guys are going to be going for it. I was watching earlier on in the practice sessions leading up to QuakeCon how Fazz and his team averages were practicing on Pillbox. I'm curious to see what is going to be happening here. Looks like we're starting right now. Here on map number 2 of the CTF section of this series. We're on Tox, but we should switch around Tox as well to try and get an attack. It looks like we're on Linkin right now.
Sure, I remember about this map. I remember watching this map the last QuakeCon and watching Brick go ham.
Yeah.
Brick was the man. But now you're telling me that Brick is no longer playing?
Apparently he's in a team with Fear, Avenged, and Effortless. We're going to QuakeCon. Goodness. Which isn't a team of superstars by any means, but it's, you know, Effortless won the raffle at QuakeCon last year, and he won $10,000.
Oh, nice.
He won more than Cypher.
That's actually amazing.
but they're playing. So Effortless is better than Cypher.
Yeah.
And, Fear, Brick, and Avenged. That's a really exciting team. But anyway, let's stick with these guys as the regen has been dropped, and the fact that Deliberate Murder have it is not so disastrous. They haven't actually leaked a cap in the first 60 seconds.
That kind of throbbing sound is the sound of the regen, slowly taking your health up by 5 at a time.
By 15 if you've got less than 100 health there. And it's using that medkit there. As we explained earlier, that's an immediate plus 100 health for you. You use it whenever you like, and we also... It's not uncommon to laugh at attackers who forget to use it, because it should be a life-saving resource. And Latrommi's really slowly moving his way into that. I think he took far too long. It's like, yeah, we know you're there. As soon as you come around the corner, there's not going to be just one of us now to defend. There's going to be two or three of us. So you might as well get this attack done quickly. Linkin, though, with a flag touch. He's on 8 health at the moment. Slowly his health is going down. This shouldn't be a successful run. Yeah, there we go. The Russian's actually quite quick to get to him. And Fortune with a nice stack. Maybe this is down to sending your defender forward. Something he could have considered. But as soon as you take a rail like that, you wanna stack up a bit more.
Yeah, so he's looking pretty strong there. The rails, though, the rail battles always can be very frustrating in mids of any CTF map. Fortune losing pretty much everything there to that, and he's going to restack up a little bit. And in the meantime, it feels like Meltdown have a better grasp of mid due to that little rail skirmish. Now, I'm curious as to what's going to happen with the next regen, actually, because regen can give you a lot of good attacking opportunities, or if it's a quad.
Yeah, it could be a quad.
Let's see the quad. I want to see the quad.
Quad would be good. It's going to be up in 4 seconds. Well, a power up will be linking in a quick touch on the flag. And there it is. Power up's up. Let's see who's going to be picking up. Zyrinx gets a quad, but he is so damn weak. Machine gun going to whittle him down. But now Latrommi is extremely weak. Linkin to pick it up. And is he going to be a scout? There's a 50 health bubble right next to him, but he's going to leave it there for a teammate. Oh. This is nice of him. Very generous, Linkin.
Yeah, Winz has everything but LG too to work with. He's gonna have to be, I'm not sure if he picked up an LG, but here he goes into the red base, and he's hitting everything so far. If he can get the hit rail on this last player, he's got the all the armor. That'd be so good for the offense.
Good defense though from the Russians there, because he was looking pretty vicious as he was moving into their side of the base. But they had good positioning, and they managed to avoid taking another rail. If Winz got that third frag, I think that would have been base in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think he's just stacking back up again. He kind of needs to get some health there. That kind of sucks if he would die without using any of the armor. But here we go. We have more battles in mid. And it's all about... There's a lot of luck to this map, because you don't know necessarily whether it's going to be a quarter or a regen.
Mm-hmm.
And so, in theory, it'd be better, I think, if it did alternate so that you could know. Because otherwise... You know, if you're in a troubling spot and you really need that quad to spawn, but then it's like a regen, you're like, oh.
But yeah, the RNG factor kind of is always debatable, and if it's good, but it's also kind of exciting, because then you've got to adapt your strategy as the item comes. So a lot of teams might be, okay, if we get a quad, we'll be aggressive. If we get a regen, we'll be defensive. You know, but it doesn't have to be as black and white as that. You can do things however you want. And, you know, if your cap's behind, then you're going to have to try and use the regen offensively anyway. A map like Ironworks, there's only the regen there. So you have to be aggressive with it. Looks like we've got the flag from both sides being touched simultaneously. So maybe we'll get our first cross-cap situation of the entire game. Pavel just wasn't even looking at him there. Linkin with 8 health left. Is there anyone else standing in his way? I mean, Linkin has a little bind there saying something. I didn't quite catch what it said.
I think that was a quote by me as well. I don't remember saying that. Just making it up as he goes along. Maybe I said that sometime. I don't know.
Well, either way, Meltdown are now 1 cap ahead, but instead of 42 seconds, it took them closer to 5 minutes, so that's at least somewhat promising for the Deliberate Murder guys. But they need more Pavel with a regen. Oh, he just ticked up to 80 health, and the 80 damage rail is going to connect with him before he can health up any more than that.
There you go, so that 1-0 is starting to be felt here by the Deliberate Murder, but they've got lots of time to play with, and perhaps they'll get lucky and get one of those quad pickups on a player that's got a lot of armor and health. Because you can really stack up the main defense really, really well. The only issue is that, you know, against Meltdown, because they're, again, so good at damaging their opposition, you have to be so on point as the flag defender. That's why he needs to be your best aim star, because he needs to be able to get kills quickly to preserve his stack. That really goes a long way when the power-up spawn as well. And Zyrinx is out of the base again. How far can he go this time, though?
You can see that he's trying to get out of the base anyway, but he's done next to no damage to his opponents. He's just weaving his way around. That's his first frag that he's had since he got the flag. And he's had the flag now for maybe, what, 20 seconds or so? And trying to get to mid, but the Russians are there waiting for him. Still going to be 1-0 to MD. But come on, Deliberate Murder, come on, step it up. Want to see some caps. We haven't had a single cap from them yet.
Yeah, that's one of those spots where Deliberate Murder have been doing a good enough job in contesting middle that Zyrinx felt forced at that point to go into middle, but it was too premature. You know, he didn't have any support in the base, in the enemy base, and his teammates weren't able to have presence on mid either at that point, but he just had to go. So, you know, sometimes flag runs just go like that, but we'll have to see if more mid control can be found by the team of the flag carrier. Nice railing there from Latrommi. He's going to be going in right now, trying to force an entrance for his teammates, but Toxic, that's so key to just get Toxic low. However, the power-ups will still go to Meltdown here onto Winz with that regen.
There's no armor behind him at the moment, but he's not looking terrible. And I think he's just trying to clear out his base a little bit. He's got perfect timing on this red armor. Linkin, though, during this time, is going to get a flag touch. And he's doing good damage. Jumps up to the teleporter. There's no red waiting for him over here, but I'm loving the movement from him at the moment.
Yeah, gorgeous play. And this is the thing again. He's waiting for any items, but also waiting for support and also waiting for the call.
He's got timing. It's good timing.
That mid is going to be clear. So can he make it? He needs to get this rocket perfect, and he will. Killer goes down, but he still needs the information from his teammates as to what's going on in mid. He's just going to take the frags, though. That's so key. And the last rocket... Oh, no, actually, he replenished all his rockets, and he's going to make it out of there alive. Good stuff from Linkin. Gets another cap in the bag.
That's another example of why he's one of the best attackers in the world. He's just very patient. He's very aware of the items that are up in the enemy's base. He's hitting the shots anyway, he's got perfect route, and his teammates are communicating things to him. Latrommi, I don't know how you're alive still. No 50 health bubble, mate.
Oh my god.
Sorry. I found a 25.
Thank god. That's the worst feeling ever, you got a red and 1 HP.
Yeah.
How did he... I don't even know how he
looks. It makes your butt cheeks clench. It's a horrible feeling as an attacker. Well, it doesn't matter what position you're in.
I'm surprised he picked it up even, but we're going to have the return there. Latrommi is
delivering. Rail from Zyrinx there.
This guy has some of the most... When he's on, he's got the most ridiculous railing.
Yeah.
So fun to watch.
The thing is, at Quakecon last year, he was playing really good early on in the tournament, but when it mattered, when they were getting deep, he really, I think, lost his edge. And I think that's maybe less, you know, LAN experience at that level.
Yeah.
And I think that really harmed him. But, you know, Winz here, he's getting a cap. Seems like a pretty straightforward one. It hasn't really encountered many Deliberate Murder players. And that is now 3-0. Pavel, though, has got himself a quad. And it's... No.
I love your reaction there. Like, nope.
He's just losing. You need to cherish every single point of that armor. But he's got into the enemy base. There's three deliberate murder players. Linkin chasing him. And we got Latrommi, who's managed to pick up the flag. I think the quad damage is almost redundant at this point. Zyrinx does go down, but it's a mutual frag at that point. And the MD flag should go back to its podium. Yep, there we go.
It's going to be a 3-0, a clean 3-0 so far for Meltdown. That looked quite scary, though, that sequence from Deliberate
Murder.
It wasn't
bad. It really wasn't bad. Yeah. You know, they had a lot of players together, but they started separating. Their objectives started to be very different in the way his teammates were clearing out the way to go through the top part of mid. And then Latrommi was like, hey, I'm going to go and see if I can desperately move down this way because I'm getting pretty low now. You want to stick with your teammates because then even if you die, your teammates could be alive. And obviously, I didn't have the information to know how low his teammates were. But you want to be close to your teammates so they can pick up the flag if, for instance, you do die.
Yeah. All right. Well, the stack on Toxic is starting to look pretty monstrous again, and with the Paris spawning in 30 seconds, okay, I was about to say, if he could hold on to this, it's completely gone, and he's dead.
Nice.
Forget everything I just said. Forget all of it.
That's important, actually. Then, you know, there's a few windows of time there where maybe Deliberate Murder can do something. Zyrinx has got the flag, and he had the med kit as well, so taking ages to take him down. In fact, he still has the flag. Cooler, though, with a run, he's pretty stacked. This has all been opened up for him because of that frag on Toxic. I think we've got a cross-cap situation for the first time this entire series. Oh no, the flag's gone down. We might get a cap here from Deliberate Murder. Cooler's so stacked at the moment. Come on, Cooler. Make it to the flag.
Oh,
where's
Zyrinx.
Cooler gone? There we go. He did it. It's on the board, guys. And woo! Deliberate Murder has made their first cap in 31 minutes of CTF play.
Nice. That's the first time I think we've seen Cooler, actually. In I think it's the first time the camera has actually really gone to Gula.
Yeah, I don't think we've seen him at all.
And he turns up to cap.
This map, at least. Good job, Gula. And he had the stack working for him as well, though. He wasn't really taken down at all. And maybe the MD guy's focusing on the wrong player. The flag is going to go back to base. MD is safe. They've only got two caps to catch up from. This is still possible, guys. You know, what it was a 3-0 isn't a massive lead. But you're going to need some very good coordination and experience as well to have to do it against a team like MD.
Yeah, absolutely. Two more caps to go, and the Paraf is spawning in 1 minute, so there is time to just chill at the moment, just build up a little bit. And Toxic is, again, just... He's not going too deep into mid, not as deep as he was in the previous map, and he's just getting some rails off there. You have to be so careful at preserving this track, though. The thing is, do you give up mids in Toxic's position and not really risk raiding in so you can preserve stack for the power up, or do you actually not care about running the power up at all and just always have presence on mid? Because I think that second approach is probably more consistent.
I think it is, at least given the situation they're in at the moment where they have got a nice lead.
Yeah.
Then it's kind of good to have that offensive defense, if
yeah,
you will.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely.
But, you know, if you are looking for caps more urgently, then you've really got to think about, okay, how can I use this as efficiently as possible in order to help us get a cap?
Yeah, it was something I think I saw favored by the American teams last Quakecon quite a lot on this map. Really, they got so many flag runs with the guy who had 200 armor and even maybe like a med kit as well. So they were 200-200.
Yeah.
So that was pretty interesting to see, but we're going to have another battle here as the power does spawn, but which one is it going to be?
It was nice there from Cooler, by the way, to steal the enemy medkit. That was very good for Cooler. Zyrinx will get the power up in the end, but some resources have at least been taken out of their hands. 10 health, I think winz. Is he going to get this? Okay, there's just full rocket ammunition there. So we'll see that quad carrier being picked up in a moment, and winz has got it. He picks up the red. He's got a brilliant stack. You can see he's got all of the important weapons as well. Is a cap going to happen here? Cooler spawning in front of him. Latrommi with some weapons going to go down as well. It's going to be another frag here for winz, making a fourth there. Excellence everywhere. Linkin though picks up the flag because he's got a lot more health and armor. That quad is now down and out, and Linkin is just flying his way across the map. That is going to be cap number four in a moment.
Ruined. ruined the run.
The flow has just disappeared there, Linkin. How dare you? But no, really, really nice. That was a 101. Flag cap there.
Yeah, that was very nicely done. It's just the fact that winz gets to the base after killing about 10 people or something with the LG and quad, and then Linkin's just sat there. So yeah, I got
it's
a red and mega guys.
I'll do the rest. I'll take it from here.
I got 200 100s. It's like just sitting there 200 100. Like, Okay.
That's where, you know, Dylan Murder's doing something wrong. If they've got, they're going up against two players that are as stacked as that, then there's a flaw with the game plan.
Yeah, it's not working out too well, but yes, it's against Meltdown. It's always going to be hard to keep up with the sheer fighting power that they bring to the to all of the battles in this map, because they're just all so good individually. So that's going to be an issue sometimes.
Yep.
So Deliberate Murder have done well not to concede too many flags, actually. They've only conceded three so far. Because I would definitely, you know, posit that Meltdown are by far the best, the better team out of these two.
Yeah.
In CTF, especially.
In CTF, for sure. No doubt about it. Especially when Meltdown come from the sort of unknown tag that was really commonly associated with the best team in CTF. And a lot of teams very close next to them, but as you know, it's always that unknown team getting ahead. We've got low touch from Linkin, and look at the stack again. He's an attacking player with 200-100, doing inane amounts of damage.
Yeah, and he got across mid, and he still has 175-70. So he took like 50 damage and on the way out.
He's going to clear up a cap there. We've got Latrommi, though, who's got the power up. I don't see any reason why... There we go. Finally, Linkin gets himself to his home flag. 5-1, 4.5 minutes to go. Hope is drifting away for Deliberate Murder to possibly make it into the finals of this this team event here on the Road2Quakecon tournament.
It's so stressful as well to be a defender and to let a flag go, and you're calling it, and you're calling it, and you're so hoping that, if let's say, maybe even if you mess up a little bit, that one of your attacking players or one of your teammates is going to be able to find the return.
Yeah.
That's such a stressful moment for you. And
it is.
CTF is generally quite stressful because there's so many clutch shots that are required. You get one shot at this guy who's got the flag and he's trying to make his way across mid. You get one chance.
It's very easy to shift blame as well on CTF.
Yeah.
It's very easy to find out, okay, who cocked up. And you don't want to be that guy.
No one wants to be that guy.
Exactly. But fortunately for MD, they don't make a whole lot of mistakes.
Maybe some people do want to be that guy.
Really?
It's just like they're massive trolls. They just join teams to troll.
I don't think they get very far, though, to be fair.
That's true.
They get filtered out quite early on in the lower divisions.
Alright, so Kilo is trying to time this...
The thing is, I don't want to be a bastard or anything, but I'm going to be. But if Deliberate Murder joined a CTF league, I wouldn't put them in the top division. And it sucks to say. I just don't think... The thing is, most of the Division 1 teams, they've been playing CTF for so long, and they usually do grind their way up from the lower divisions to get to the top divisions. You know, very few teams just start from the top. And I think really Deliberate Murder have got to focus a lot more on their TDM, I'd say. If they're for preparing for QuakeCon, I'd say, look, you're meant to be TDM experts. You're meant to be the champions of Europe. You need to go and make sure you win that title at QuakeCon. I think Meltdown are far more focused on winning the CTF at QuakeCon, but apart from maybe Tox, I think Tox would love to win everything.
Oh, yeah.
But Deliberate Murder, I don't think they've got enough time to get their CTF game up to a level where they can think about beating Americans or the likes of MD or averages, but they can work their TDM up to a high level. They have got time to practice that, and that's what they should focus on.
Yeah, I think so as well. Like, the TDM is so clearly going to be giving them much more opportunities. But the thing is that if you're going to run into Meltdown, I mean, I think Meltdown are the worst possible team for them to face, because the individual skill gap can change things quite significantly. I feel like against averages, they're going to have a better time, but still averages are very, very, very good individually. But averages, I would expect to play a more predictable and just generally good style of TDM, which is something that I think would be easier for Deliberate Murder to handle, as opposed to Meltdown, who just break all the rules because they're just so good.
Yeah.
Individually, they just break the rules of how the game should be played, in most senses. And I mean, that's what happens with star level, star power players, star level players. It's just they break the rules and they're able to do things that you can't easily plan for.
But it's not just that their aim is so good as well; it's just their experience in the game modes as well. Because I'd argue that the iGamers players individually have a higher average accuracy than the MD players, but I would definitely not say they're as good on TDM or CTF.
I think the only real weakness, potentially, which is kind of like weird to say, is Zyrinx, because you know, when it comes to LAN at least,
yeah,
as you mentioned, Zyrinx, he probably needs more experience still. He's not played to his potential on LAN, because the guy is a very big game player, mm-hmm, usually. But when it comes to LAN, as you say, he's not performed. And he's the other thing as well that I think we have to take into account, especially with TDM, is that Zyrinx's skill sets are more naturally suited to when he's being you know, fed some items here and there. He doesn't need a lot of items, but he needs something to work with, unlike, you know, Toxic, unlike, you know, Linkin. You know, Winz is a player that you also want to, like, feed him some stuff, because he can be really, really sick and, yeah, very efficient. But, you know, I think Zyrinx might find a role issue sometimes with a team like this, but does it really matter? I mean, you got Toxic, you got Winz, you got Linkin.
His confidence is really going to rise through being with this caliber of teammates, I think. And right, he's the Quakecon Open Duel Champion of last year as well, mm-hmm, beating Gerper, I think it was.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
In last year's final. So that was pretty humorous. And the deliberate meta guys started disconnecting quite quickly, so we won't see too many of their stats. But yeah, that was a convincing. Not just a convincing CTF part from MD, but an entire series altogether. I honestly stand true to my words. Deliberate Murder should have performed better on the TDM.
Yeah, they really would have been nice to have seen them win Dreadful Place.
Mm-hmm.
They just didn't get the quads, though. They just could not get the quads, and they couldn't get any clean runs going.
It was always MD were a step ahead and preparing for the quad. They were taking care of the quad room a lot better, and whatever way Deliberate Murder tried to push in, just never really seemed to work. Pavel managed to get a nice run by just sneaking in the last second, but it was really after that, the map, the points where it mattered, MD had it on lockdown.
Yeah, I mean, there's so many quads that got out for Meltdown, mm-hmm, and did damage, but even when they did that, they still didn't have as good map control as they could have done afterwards, because they'd always get quite a lot of kills out of it. So Deliberate Murder were able to actually slow down the bleeding quite significantly after the quad wears off. They're still picking up items and stuff, even though there are spots where I feel like they didn't support, you know, I think Cooler, mm-hmm, enough, because Cooler was in this position where he's your stable base of control. And again, when you're playing against guys with such insane damage output, yeah, constantly, of course it's going to be hard to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But generally speaking, because they didn't have that to work with, they were always scrambling for weapons. They could never get a solid base. Then leading into the quad fights, they just weren't never really present enough, so that sunk them completely. But I feel like they if it was a better start, they could potentially have won that, but they got kind of a horrendous start, because we saw a super fast quad for Meltdown, and they turned that into a big lead. I think it was like a 20 frag lead straight away.
Yeah, it was so very fast. Even in the first minute, I think it went to something like 15-7 or less.
Yeah,
you know, less time
like
than
that.
A minute.
Yeah.
They very rapidly got control of the map. If maybe Deliberate Murder, maybe they had nicer spawns, or they managed to get at least the first part of the map control, then I don't know how it would have played out. I don't know how long it would have taken MD to maybe get into that map. But yeah, Dreadful Place was obviously a big turning point in the entire series, because that's something that Deliberate Murder needed to pick up. So we didn't get to see even a tiebreaker in the TDM. And then going into CTF, every day of the week, there was going to be MD having every advantage there.
Yeah, yeah.
So fortunately, we are going to be saying goodbye to Deliberate Murder, but we will have Zyrinx, Tox, Linkin, and Winz waiting in the final to play up against one of the opponents in the next semi-final, which is going to be either Team iGamers or Team Averages. That is going to consist of Silencep, clawz, Strengths, and Cypher on the first team, which is a bit of a mixed team, if I'm honest. These guys want to go to Quakecon, they want to play together. They have got insane aim, but how is that team cohesion going to come into play? Because they're going up against Team Averages, which really aren't that average when it comes to their team play. Demon, Fazz, Sparty, and Noctis. Going to be a pretty interesting series. This one is...
I'm looking forward to this quite a lot, actually.
I think I've still got to say this has got to be a 2-0 overall in TDM and CTF for Team Averages.
Too, yeah.
But the thing is, if the iGamers can get to Duel, that's when they can lock it down and try and get that grand final spot. So we'll have to see. But I think we're taking a break now, right?
Yep, I think so. I think it's time for a break. It will be... When are we going live again, Mr. Producer Reese? So there could be between 1 and 2 hours.
Yeah, so guys, there's a fairly large break at the moment, So get some housework done. Go get yourself a beverage.
Yeah, you always mention the housework, porridge. Man. How?
Like, that's when I have to do housework, man.
I was going to say, what's going on at your house? You have to like find every spare moment to do some housework.
The thing, when I'm doing, well, I'm just really messy. No, when I'm watching streams or something like
just
that, I don't like doing it while the game is on or anything like that. So I've got to wait for the break. So I was like, God damn it, I don't want to do anything else but watch the stream at the moment. So that's when I get my
My favorite is usually getting the ironing board out, having... like a Thorin's
like
Forts.
Like Torgud did yesterday.
Yeah. Get the ironing done whilst I'm like have Thorin's Forts on one monitor and like a center stream on the other monitor.
That's
like
pretty good.
Some gameplay.
Yeah.
That's my usual.
You guys can do that. Yeah. Get the ironing board out, guys. We'll be back in 1 or 2 hours for the next semi-final here on the road to Quakecon Team Day.